Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
We begin in San Francisco, where an elderly Filipino woman was shoved into an oncoming train on Monday night, causing her death. 74-year-old Corazon Dandan was doing her normal routine of coming home from her shift at a local hotel. She was waiting for a train at the Powell Street BART station when the suspect, 49-year-old Trevor Belmont, allegedly pushed her as a train was approaching. Dandan hit her head on the train and fell on the platform. She later died at the hospital. Belmont, who is described as a transient, was arrested for murder shortly after the incident. The BART Police Department and investigators are reportedly working to determine a motive for this incident as they're interviewing witnesses and processing evidence, including surveillance video. The Philippine-born Dandan migrated to San Francisco in the 1980s. While she had no children of her own, she helped put her nieces and nephews to school. In sports, another Filipino-American has punched her ticket to the Summer Games in Paris. The Philippine Athletics Track and Field Association announced that Lauren Hoffman has qualified for the 400-meter hurdles. Hoffman, a Duke University graduate, was in Southern California last May with pole vaulter E.J. Obiena for the Los Angeles Grand Prix.
It just means a lot, you know. I feel like there's not a lot of people that look like me competing at such a high level. You know, for EJ and I to be the only, like, Philippine athletes here, it's just really special, and I hope, like, more Philippine athletes get to qualify for higher level events.
Last May, Hoffman was fresh from the Philippine National Championships and was maintaining her top 40 ranking, which eventually led to her first Olympic berth. The Virginia-born Hoffman was a highly decorated athlete at Duke. Her personal best of 55.47 in the 400-meter hurdles is a Duke record. While she has also reset the Philippines' 400-meter hurdles record several times, including the current 55.72 mark, Hoffman is now expected to join the Philippines' training camp in France. The first round of women's 400-meter hurdles takes place on August 5th. And finally, from baking vanilla cupcakes at 13 to starting a baking blog in 2020 during the pandemic, all the way to writing a recipe book in 2022, this 29-year-old Filipino-American baker and author recently won a coveted James Beard Award for Emerging Voice.
It meant a lot. I think it means, like, for me, this book was a miracle that it came out and it's on shelves. And I think a second miracle that it's getting recognition like this, not just for me, but like for the Filipino like community that I represent. And I just like emphasize a lot that like it's opening doors, hopefully not just for me, but like for other people looking to be in this.
Abby Balingit recently paid a courtesy call on Philippine Consul General Sinan Mangalile in New York City.
That should inspire our kababayan na kung meron kayong passion about something, ituloy ninyo.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
Turning now to the race for the White House, U.S. President Joe Biden vowing to stay in the 2024 presidential race. Sources say Biden called members of his campaign team Wednesday, telling them he was not stepping down as presidential candidate. He is also set to meet with Democratic governors to reassure them he is up to the job of being the party's standard bearer following his shaky debate performance. The White House also issuing the same message.
The president is clear-eyed, and he is staying in the race. I don't have anything else beyond that. He's staying in the race. That is what the president is promised to do. That is what he wants to continue to work on the successes that he's had. His record is unprecedented record, and that is what the president is focused on, continuing to deliver for the American people. And he looks forward to doing that.
Over in the UK, British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak continues to rally Conservatives on the eve of the July 4 general election. Talking to party activists in New Hampshire, Sunak referred to England coming back from the brink of coming back from the brink of elimination in the Euro 2024, saying the race isn't over until the final whistle blows. Despite this, Bravado's latest polls show a record win for the opposition Labour Party.
We have 24 hours left. We do not surrender to Labour. We will fight for every vote. We will fight for our values, and we will fight for our vision of Britain.
The Labour leader also seeking to rally supporters ahead of the landmark election that looks set to end the 14 years of Conservative rule. Labour's final campaign push focused on fears that voters could stay at home, seeing the result as a foregone conclusion.
Every single vote has to be earned. We have to go out there and make the case. Change only happens if you vote for it. And imagine... And imagine a different future Friday morning, a Labour government elected in.
Progress in talks for a proposed ceasefire in Gaza. After weeks with little public diplomacy, mediators delivered a response from Hamas to a proposal that would include the release of hostages and a ceasefire in the enclave. The Mossad spy agency says Israel is now studying Hamas's response. Egypt, Qatar, and the United States have been trying for months to secure a truce and the release of 120 remaining hostages in Gaza. But their efforts have repeatedly failed. Hamas says any deal must end the war and bring a full Israeli withdrawal from Gaza. But for Israel, it will accept only temporary pauses in the fighting until Hamas is eradicated. Hurricane Beryl now moving northwest towards the Cayman Islands. The Category 4 storm turned over Jamaica on Wednesday after forging a destructive path across smaller Caribbean islands over the past couple of days. The death toll has risen to at least 9, but it is widely expected to rise as communications come back online. Beryl is packing maximum sustained winds of 225 kilometers per hour. It is expected to weaken slightly, but remain at near major hurricane strength as it moves to the Caymans.